So we will try to escape a little bit from the surface, if you don't mind, for this last talk. I'm Vincent Genot from CDPP. So CDPP is a French plasma physics data center in Toulouse and also in other lab in France. And we are developing different tools for mostly plasma physics. And today I will describe our tool, which is called 3DView, which helps to visualize planetary data in context. And this is a tool developed by CDPP, GFI, which is a French company, and CNES, a French spatial agency. So 3DView is an open source Java software. The address, you can try it now if you want, is 3dview.cdpp.eu. We will provide a demo tomorrow, also in track B, yes. And so the aim of the tool is to plot 3D data in a planetary context. This is designed by CDPP and developed by GFI, I told that. So what kind of data? So basically, the tool was done for orbits and attitude of spacecraft. Now we can plot in-situ measurement by onboard instruments, so which means for plasma physics, mainly scalar quantities, vectors, spectrograms. And this is mainly done for plasma data, but there is no restriction to this. We can also plot simulation and model results, like 2D cuts from 3D models, field and flow line, as I will show. And this is also mainly done for the moment for solar wind interaction with planet, but there is no restriction to that. And we are trying and starting to develop mapping functionalities for any quantity that can be mapped on the surface. And this is our interest into this GIS workshop. Some of this functionality, as I have to mention, have been developed in the frame of IMPEX, which is a FP7 project, which is ending at the end of this month, actually. It was a 4 years, four partner project, including these labs in France, in Finland, Russia, and in Austria. And the aim is to provide a work environment of different tools to plot, analyze planetary plasma physics, and comparing simulation and observation. So the functionalities that have been developed for 3DView in this frame are boundary models like magnetopause, shock, etc. Magnetic field models, and this is an important thing that I will come back in during this presentation. This is the key point, the key feature to link spatial observation and surface maps, because mostly in plasma physics, particles travel along magnetic field line, and so we need magnetic field models. We can upload user orbits in the tool. We can access direct, we have a direct access to databases like AMDA or the CEDO web, if you know these databases for plasma physics. And we have access to simulation databases. And we enabled the IVOA SOM protocol for those who know that. So now I will provide a few views of what we can do. The aim is not to make a complete demo of the tool, just a few snapshots. So I'll start from the larger view, and I will come back to the surface. I will come to the surface at the end of the talk. So here we have the Earth somewhere. We have different spacecraft orbiting the Earth. And here what I'm plotting is a magnetic field as measured by the satellite Themis B and C, which are orbiting the moon, and the cycloid here that you see, and some magnetic field measurement, real magnetic field measurement done along this track. We can plot spectrogram also. These are spectrogram measured along the VEX orbit around Venus. A bit of statistics here. In the heliosphere, so here what you have is ACE data around the L1 point. Here you have the geotail data around the Earth. So here you have 3 years of density measured by geotail, and here 3 years of magnetic field measured by ACE. So you can see the correspondence between the two, and here you can see the magnetosheath, which is visible directly into the data. Okay. Coming closer to our aim here, magnetic field measurement by the Rosetta spacecraft along the Rosetta trajectory around the 67P comet. So the aim of all these tools is to compare observation and measurement, so measurement here and simulation, sorry, in different contexts. And all what we need to come closer to the surface is magnetic field model. So we have a different kind of model into the tool. So we have Parker spiral for heliospheric model. So this is interplanetary magnetic field. We have some model around the Earth. But what we need for other bodies, like here Ganymede, we need simulation or analytical model. Here what we have is a model, a 3D model from LATMOS. So this is a hybrid model, kind of particle in cell code, at least for the ion. And this is a magnetic field line around, around Ganymede. And this is a scene done for JUICE in 2033 for the future ESA Jupiter mission. Other kind of view, so this was magnetic field line, and here are magnetic measurements that could be seen here by Galileo in 1996, I think, and here the same kind of view, but in 2033 with JUICE, and in both cases, this is a spacecraft orbiting around, or here this is a flyby, and here this is orbiting Ganymede. This I will skip. So you've seen that in 3D view, we have a different kind of magnetic field model as this one. We have magnetic field model for Mercury, for Jupiter, Saturn, the Earth mainly, and also for Mars, we have some crustal field model. So now we need some mapping, some map functionalities. And this is very rudimentary. That's, this is why we came to this workshop, actually, to understand a little bit more what we can do. For the moment, it's basically mapping a map on a round object or spherical object. So here are some maps. This is the interface where we can only choose a map coming from a file. Maybe very soon, we will be able to directly load a map from a given URL or, and soon databases. So here I uploaded some a map at, for clouds at 500 kilometers, why not? And what we can do also is do the same for Mars. So here we have some a map for crystal field coming from, I don't remember which model. This is a ferric composition coming from MEX, from Omega. And this comes from PSA, actually. And this is directly a mapping of this map on the surface of Mars. But we can go not only on a planet, but also on the sun. So here, this is a magnetogram coming from the Gong network. So this is a network mapping the magnetic field of the sun every 6 hours, I think. So here, this is what solar orbiter could view in a few years from now. If we had this kind of map at this time. Okay, so what we need in all this is both to have something on the surface of the planet, but it can be surface, but also it can be atmosphere, it can be ionosphere, so all this extends to a few hundred kilometers. So we have both here what we need, the map and magnetic field line to make the connection. So we need the third dimension, and we have been discussing a little bit today in some discussion. We need also time, and I see some, I show here some of the data we'd like to map into the tool. Here you have some convection maps from the ionosphere, so these are polar views, which are taken every 10 minutes, so we would need something quite fast to integrate all this data. Here are all sky imager for aurora coming from the Themis network. And here are some maps of aurora on Jupiter as well. But we have less smaller cadence for this kind of image, but also we have a need for that. So the third dimension is needed, and also not spherical objects to make projection. And here are some illumination models for 67P that we started doing, and some mapping, and this kind of map to get a proper time resolution. You have to get them every 2 minutes during the comet rotation. So high cadence also. So typically, GIS use case for 3D view, we need the magnetic field lines to map spatial to surface connection. When I say surface, this can be atmosphere or ionosphere. And from this mapping at a given time and given altitude, the ideal tool will propose all available information at this location, at this time, and also later and before. We could also aim to do the reverse operation, starting from the surface or given altitude, and looking back into space to see what kind of observation was done at this time in a cone, for instance, in situ observation. Okay, so the next step for 3D view is for the moment in the frame of Europlanet, S2020. We have different development which are planned. Sorry. And some of them include surface mapping, access to list of predefined maps, access to existing database for planetary maps, and if we could integrate GIS into that, it would be nice. We hope to learn a lot from this workshop. Okay, thank you.